This is Kees Blok, and I help people from doing to being. And this video, I would love to talk to you about why mindfulness matters and what it is. What is mindfulness and why does it matter? Okay, let's start. So first of all, mindfulness is, of course, an English term for being mindful, being present, being conscious of what actually is. So it's the movement which is originated from Buddhism, to be mindful, to be present in the moment, and to understand actually that the only thing that is currently is the present moment. So let's be mindful of it. Let's be conscious here. Let's not flee into our minds and live in our thoughts and our feelings, but let's be here, let's be relaxed, let's be conscious of what's happened. What's happening, and let's do that in a relaxed way. The thing I love about mindfulness is it's a very good first step of being conscious of how you are hindering yourself in many ways. So when you do mindfulness meditation, or the many nice practices or theory that mindfulness offers, you get to reflect or actually see what is happening in my mind, my body, and the environment around me when I'm quiet, when I'm relaxed, when I'm just here, when I'm watching or seeing what is actually happening. What's happening sometimes, what we can notice is that, for example, we have some emotions which we haven't given our attention, and we can start giving that our attention. Or we can notice we have some thoughts, some thoughts which require our attention, or we have situations that are happening that we haven't really seen because we were not present. We were just focusing on, we were in our heads, you know, we're not in the moment. And mindfulness is a beautiful first step also on the spiritual path to become conscious of what is actually, not only of the mind movie we've been playing all over and the emotions we're so familiar with all the time, but what is actually here, and are we maybe overreacting to what is happening? These are beautiful things. And one thing which I really love about mindfulness is you have the sort of the masculine part, and the masculine part is, you know, be like a rock in the sea that's just very strong and very zen and just there, and whatever stormy weather comes, the rock is just, you know, calm, tranquil, is just focused, is just there. And then mindfulness also has that female quality. And that female quality is being receptive, being open, being loving, being kind, being accepting to whatever arises, to the emotions, the thoughts, the feelings of others, of yourself, the sensations of a room, the energy you can feel, the circumstances, and to be there, to be present for other people, to be loving and to be kind. And what we can realize from mindfulness is also that there is a sort of inherent kindness and loving kindness, they say actually in Buddhism, that loving kindness is actually always there. And the more we're loving for ourselves and appreciate, let's say, ourselves in a non-egotistical, arrogant way, but we're just, let's say, we're kind to ourselves, we can also be kinder to others. And we can understand, if we understand ourselves a little bit more, then we can understand others also in a deeper way. Mindfulness also reveals the lens through which we look out at the world. Because if we're starting to be conscious and we realize, okay, this is what is, and whatever we think about or what label we put on it, that is actually the mind. And that's not being mindful, but that's being in the mind, right? And maybe having a full mind. And in that way, if we were talking basic English, maybe mind empty would be a better word for it, because it, then there's room, you know, there's space for other things to come in the glass. Not saying the glass half empty. Sorry, just joking, silly stuff. Now, in general, what mindfulness does is it can give you that consciousness of what is happening. And what is really happening, we can see, okay, there are two people talking, or there's one person talking to me, and they have sweet intentions, but because they say a certain thing, I'm triggered, you know. I can feel, okay, I can feel emotions rising, I can feel thoughts coming, I can feel judgments coming. And instead of saying I'm angry, we can sort of get through mindfulness, get some space and say I feel anger, instead of I'm angry. You know, I'm angry is like this, it's identified, it's one with the anger, and we can see the anger and keep our distance. And through that practice of keeping distance in a way, but giving attention, but distance and not going into them so much, through that practice and through mindfulness, which is one of the great mindfulness practices, we can learn a sort of detachment where we're not uninterested or not caring, but we're very caring. But we can see our feelings and care for them instead of identifying with them and going into them. And in this way, we can start to get a deeper and deeper understanding of what the lens is, or what the programming is, or the conditioning is that we've been actually living through, the lens through which we see the world, the judgments and the ideas we have of how the world should be instead of how it actually is without all those labels. And it's a very beautiful process to slowly become conscious of how you've been programmed, and also what your lens is. And it's one of the first steps to try to start to be able to let it go is by understanding what is actually there. And that's why, to me, mindfulness is one of the crucial steps for a further development and understanding of yourself, especially on the spiritual path, but also in any setting at all, whether that's with family, in business, with friends, or just with yourself alone in the room, or with your spouses. Any sense of what feedback you're getting, and also what is happening inside you, is very helpful to give that attention and to give that sort of loving understanding. And the more understanding you get, the more deeper you can go, and the more relaxed and tranquil, or more like the rock, we can become, while at the same time having the loving quality, where we can enter every storm, but be the eye of the storm, and give the storm attention at the same time, without being taken away by the storm. And this is one of the lovely qualities of mindfulness. So if you have any questions about mindfulness, please let me know. I'll be offering some mindfulness practices as well, and I'll be making a course soon about it. Already have a Dutch course, which I'll link below as well, for the Dutchies. And I'm still evolving. And I look forward to evolve together. So thank you for following my journey. Thank you for watching this video. And have a great day. Bye.